Anyway, what up, guys? Yo, Fupon CB here. Back with more Air. Alright, obviously, the PSP Fan Translation Edition. I don't think this game ever had a fan, official translation. So, here, bruh. Alright, July 23rd, I think that's what we're on. This is where we last left off last time, right? Misuzu was talking about her dreams of being in the sky. And then a cliffhanger right here, July
24th.
Gonna make sure everything works. Misuzu told me that on our way to school.
お前はいつも能天気だな。もしかしたら夕べも夢を見たのか。見たよ。すごく気持ちよく飛んでた。よいしょっと。Mizu
climbed onto the seawall, spread her arms wide, and walked off with unsteady footsteps. Well, let me get closer. Ah, there we go. She's probably pretending to fly. She was really without a care in the world.
おい、危ないぞ。
Slip.
Itai.
Gao?
Dakara itta daro.
Gao.
Aw, Gao.
Itai. Doushite sara ni itai me ni aou no kana?
Ora, tate.
I held out a hand to her.
Oishyo. Arigato.
Yume wa itsumo to kawari nakatta ka?
Uun. Sukoshi chigatte ta.
Donna fuuni?
同じだったけど、私が違う気持ちでいた。Mizu
got on the seawall once again. Then she turned towards the sea and sat down. The vast sky towered over before her. Before the sky was giving her hints about the world in her dream. I sat down next to her.
いつも通り、私の体が空に飛んでいる。We're
close. I just realized this game doesn't have many CGs.
足の下の雲はいつもより少なくて、海と陸が見渡せた。白い波の線が陸に押し寄せて消えたりしてた。自分が本当に高い場所にいることが分かって怖かった。そっか。うん。それでね、私はそこで悲しんでた。
It's cause she's alone, right?
あんな悲しい思いをしているのかな。The
sorrow that was imprisoned in the sky. The match my image of a girl I sought. She continued to feel the wind with her body high up in the sky. In my mind's eye, her form was that of a saintly being, almost like an angel. Her limbs were pale white. She had a pair of white wings. But if she were possessed human emotions, then her plight would be too tragic to imagine. All alone, the girl lived through the vastness of time. How much punishment had the wind inflicted on her all this time? And now, Misuzu was watching all of that, almost as if it were happening to herself. We stopped in the shade of the trees. The cicadas' voices filled the silence between us. For a long time, we said nothing. Misuzu. I spoke first.
夢だろ。お前には関係ない。お前はいつものように笑ってろ。お前が笑ってないとさ。
I feel sad as she did not smile. Why was that?
とにかく笑ってろ.
Aww. She's doing the V. I like that she doesn't just do a V sign. She has to say V every time she does it. She smiled.
ジュースでも飲めばどうだ。喉乾いたろ.
About your favorite juice, Peach.
うん。いい.
She stood up.
じゃあ、行ってくるね。
あ。居眠りすんなよ。
うん。 お昼一緒に食べるから、ここで待っててね。
あ。
Okay. She ran off. I got on top of the seawall to think about things. I turned my sweat-soaked back towards the sea and sat cross-legged. Then I looked up at the sky. Up in the sky, there's a girl with wings. She has been there since long ago. She is there even now. In the same air, she continues to feel the wind with her widespread wings. My mother told me that when I was little. I had heard the story so many times from her, it seemed almost like a lullaby. However, I knew that it wasn't that simple. My mother must have been trying to tell me something important through those words. But I couldn't remember, no matter how hard I tried. How could I have forgotten? It had to be something important.
ねえ、ユキト さん、どうして私、空の私は、あんな悲しい思いをしてるのかな?
For a moment, Misuzu had looked to be begging for help.
俺だって何も知らないんだよ、ミスズ。
We're back to the regular music. By the time I had finished with my thoughts, the sun was right overhead. The bell rang for noon. The students that came for summer school were heading home. I waited, but Misuzu did not appear. She didn't seem like the kind to stand me up. Did she have urgent business to attend to? After waiting for 1 hour, I left the seawall. I put open the door to the entranceway.
Misuzu, iru ka?
I called her name as I stepped into the hallway. There was someone in the kitchen.
Okaeri nasai.
Dang, did she forget? I thought we were having lunch together.
Gohan, ima dekita toko dakara.
Oh. I was more disappointed than angry.
Yukito-san, ase bishori.
Hasutte kita kara na.
Sonna ni onaka suite tan da.
Yes.
Machiase shita daro.一緒に帰るって。
あ。
ミズズ。
ごめん、忘れてた。
I like that face she makes. Like, ah,、oh, it's so like innocent, bro. Right? Like she, you know she didn't mean no harm. Right? There's no way, bro. She just really forgot. An innocent forgetfulness. No malice at all.She sounded indifferent.
まったく。
おわびに、お昼はごちそう。
She shoved a plate at my nose.
ユキトさんの分は、卵4つ。
I don't know, that's a lot of eggs. Is that an omelet?
形も焼き加減も完璧。
Dang, it's not an omelet. It's like a... not sunny side up, but... sunny side up, but it's fully cooked.
早く食べないと。冷めちゃうよ。
No, no topping, condiments. I'll take soy sauce.
お前な。
Well, I didn't mind as long as she was alright. I sat down at the table and picked up my chopsticks. Didn't they eat eggs with chopsticks? I eat eggs with a spoon. I can eat eggs with a chopstick too, but...I don't know why I never do. Now that I think about it, why do I always use a spoon? Maybe I'm getting like a... Americanized or something. Wait, but I am American. After the meal, I heard the sound of Misuzu humming and washing the dishes. As usual, Misuzu came to me after she was done with her chores. Dang, I'm not gonna say something, bro. I guess I can. Hey, I'm not gonna say no names, but I remember...When I was in middle school, bro, one of my teachers, right? Because on a certain subject, right? Let's just say maybe math, right? I got a question wrong. He told me I've been Americanized. I'm like, what? What does that mean? I didn't get it till like maybe a couple years later. I'm like, oh, motherfucker. To be fair, I did always have the math question white. Right.It was just that day, I didn't get it right. I've been Americanized. As usual, Misuzu came to me after she was done with her chores. Ain't nothing but love to that teacher though. That was one of my favorite teachers of all time. Very cool teacher.
Yukito-san, トランプ。
Oh. お前の持ってるのはトランプだな。
トランプしよう。
俺は忙しいんだ。
全然忙しく見えない。
考え事してるんだってな。
考え事しながらトランプ。
And so I had no choice but to play with Misuzu, even though I was busy.
つまりまたユキトさんの負け。
Dang, Yukito, how you lost?
念を押さなくていい。
もう一回やる？
やる。
I hate it losing. The war was over. Although I was pretty sure I lost most of the time.
麦茶飲もうっと。
She got up.
ユキトさんも飲む？
うん。
ちょっと待っててね。
She went to the kitchen. I remember something as I looked at the scattered cards. 3 days ago, I was playing with Mizuo like this when she was suffered a fit. It didn't seem to happen frequently. I recall what Haruko told me. She's been like that since she was little. Whenever she was just about to become friends with someone, she'd break down crying. I wonder why she never grew out of it. I didn't have in-depth knowledge of this topic, but I was quite sure that I had heard about a girl like that before. That was... I heard Mizuo's voice from the kitchen. Dang, foreshadow! He heard about a girl from that before. I wonder what that means. I went to take a look and found Trouble Misuzu at the open fridge.
麦茶作り忘れてた。
We can drink tap water.
ないなら水でいいぞ。
私のおすすめは
水だ。
私のおすすめはね、
水にしてくれ。
四角いパックに入っててね。
No peach juice.
コップに入ったただの水にしてくれ。
I'll take the tap water.
ユキトさん、付き合い悪いな。
Rummage, rummage.
ジュースの買い置きも終わってる。買いに行かないと。
今からか。
夜に飲む分ないから。
Damn.
ユキトさんも来てくれる？
まさかあそこの自販機か。
あのシリーズ。他に売ってないから。
I wonder why. She wanted the rich, gooey kind after all.
あんなもの好んで飲んでると、
友達
なくすぞ。
I don't know if I ever drank something gooey. Hey, maybe. I guess I did. There's some like Asian drinks that's like gooey, but I'm not a big fan of it. I remember there was this Asian drink that's like a. It's something like basil or something like that, and it had like seeds in it.That shit was kind of good. It was kind of good.
Yukito-san, 友達.
Oh! Did she get over her trauma? So I had to go out with her. I followed Mizuo at a snail pace. I was already late in the afternoon. The color of the sunlight was visibly changing as we advanced.By the time we got to the coast, the sun was already setting.
夕焼け空も好き。どこかに帰れそうな気がするから。
Mizu's shadow was long. Her hair quivered in the wind and glimmered. I swore I had seen this picture before. Was it when I was little and still traveling with my mother? I looked up at the sky for no reason. The clouds were drifting under the orange sun. The remnants of the loss were lingering in the darkness of dusk.When night fell, they would all disappear without a trace.
この空の向こうには翼を持った少女がいる。それはずっと昔から。そして今この時も同じ大気の中で翼を広げて風を受け続けている。
I said those words out loud. The continuation of those sentences surfaced in my mind. Up there, the girl is having the same dream over and over again.The girl is always alone. She fades away before she has the chance to grow up. She keeps dreaming the same sad dream. I return my gaze to the ground. What was that just then? I repeated those words once more in my mind to prevent myself from forgetting. Up there, the girl is having the same dream over and over again. No matter how many times she is reborn, She will never find happiness. The girl is always alone, and she will die alone. That's what my dreams are like. They were too abstract. Did I dream up those words because my vision of the sunset and Misuzu has something in common? Or was it something else? There was still more to what I could recall. Something more important. However, that something was locked away in the murky depths of my mind. Something else was creeping out. A premonition of sadness. No. I finally broke out of my trance to speak to Misuzu, but she wasn't there.
Misuzu?
She was there. She was in front of the vending machine. I sighed and ran over to her.
ごめんね.
Dang, I got scared. He was like, she's not there. What the hell? And then he like blinked twice. I'm like, oh, she's right there.
新商品ないかなって。 あ、これ前に飲んで美味しかった。買って帰ろうっと。
Okay. She took out her purse and fished for coins. Watching Misuzu, I came to a conclusion.
わけがわからない夢の話なんて、こいつには似合わないよな。
こういうことをしている時が一番こいつらしくていい。ちょっと待ってね。100円玉よかったかな。あ、ゆっくりすればいい。
I wait patiently. Mizu stood beside me, groaning as her search for 100 yen coin continued. I was spacing out while watching TV. I had to think. For Mizu's sake, I had to use every bit of my head. But that was something I wasn't very good at.
Yukito-san, Trump.
Misuzu came to me after she got done with her bath.
Trump.
それしかないのか、お前は。
だから、Trump.
な、俺は今何をしてる?
暇してる。
テレビを見てるんだよ。
Conversations such as these were becoming woven into our daily lives.
何見てるの?
さあ。
I really did not know. A young cop was running from place to place.
退屈。
What?
黙ってお前も見ておけ。
途中からじゃわけわかんない。
That is true.
最初から見ておけばよかったんだ。
Damn, got her.
私、洗い物してたし。
Well, you should have left the dishes dirty.
そうか。 そら残念だな。
トランプは?
これ終わったらな。
夜遅くなっちゃうね。だな。眠くなる。明日があるだろ。うん、そうだね。
It finally became quiet. The man in TV was making a deduction.
謎は解けた。犯人は。犯人は?
Fish. The image vanished.
犯人は誰だ?
Oh! What the hell, Misuzu? Oh, I just said she's so innocent. Zero malice in her bones. She just turned off the TV during the big plot twist.
お前だ。お前がいないだろ。正解。消したのはミスズチン。
Oh my god, that's evil.
ミスズチンは困ったやつだな。
I turned to Misuzu.
トランプしてくれるの?
Alright, I guess.
うれしいな。
She took out the cards from the case and began shuffling. Oh, your mom's here.
どうやってするんだ?
これはやり方難しいけどね。 覚えるとすごく面白いよ。
大変そうだな。
Stomp, stomp, stomp. The door slid open.
おかえり。早かったね。もう少し早かったら一緒にご飯食べられたのに。
What the hell? What kind of retort is that? To your own daughter? She looked at Mrs. and scrunched up her face.
あんたのんきなもんやな。あれだけ心配させといて、自分はトランプで夜更かしかいな。
Why? Is this still her birthday? No. Her birthday was like yesterday, I think. I can't understand what she just said.
おかげでこっちは仕事が一つ不意になってしもた。
Homma, Misuzu-chan wa komatta ko ya ne.
Flat, flat. Misuzu begins to lay out the cards.
Hora, asobo, Yukito-san.
Aka, aka. Kore kara wa otona no jikan ya. Kodomo wa nerun ya.
Yukito-san, watashi to nemutaku naru made asonde kureru tte.
Soko made wa itte nai ga.
Isoro wa maiban uchi to nonderu in ya. Na, Isoro?
No, I don't. Haruko moved her face closer to me.
Kyou wa nanka uchi mukatsuiteru kara erai koto ni natte shimaisou ya.
Oh god.
Mou suppompo ni natte shimaitai kibun ya.
Oh god, bro. When she said herself, she meant you, bro. You gotta get naked.
Donai? Kyoumi aru yaro?
I'm not falling for that twice.
Osoroshii gurai ni nai.
Nanchu keiyo ya ne?
She strangled me.
Kurushii daro.
Oh fuck. She's really choking him. Misuzu, help. A scuffle messed up the car's laid out on the floor.
Moi.
Damn.
Watashi neru.
Oh no. Misuzu picked up the cars one by one instead of.
Oyasumi.
Dang, her mom's mean. She left the room just like that.
Kora! Sake-kusai iki o hakikakeru na!
Waru yoi shiteru ne.
Iria wakaru.
Kimochi warui ne.
Oh, turn the other way.
Nara hanareru.
Haruko grabbed my collar and pressed her forehead to mine.
Anta ikutsu ya? Atachi ka sokura ero?
Sonna mon da na.
Honnara oya no kimochi nante wakarahen ne yaro na.
Sou da na.
Uchi mo wakarahen. Anta to sonai ni toshi kawarahen sakai ni na.
Anta no sahodo kawaranai wa nanjuu nen ka wa shiranai.
Oh, fuck.
Honno chotto ya nen.
She's touching her old.
Shimeru na.
Aho rashi.
She released me and sat down on the spot.
Gakko de kanshaku okosu nante koko no tokoro nakattan ya de.
Oh, what? I guess I don't know, man. I should have thought about that, right? It would be strange she only had a fit at home, right? Of course she would have a fit at school too.
Sore mo na. Dare ka to asondetan ya nakute hitori de ite nakidashita tte iu ne.
Every time she spoke, I could smell the sickly sweet smell of alcohol.
Nani ga attan da?
Anta, ano ko kara kiitehen no?
Nani mo kiite nai.
As far as I knew, Misuzu was acting normal today. Except for the fact that she went home by herself instead of meeting me at the seawall.
Mata kanshaku ya. Gakkou de taureta de rennaku haittan ya.
That's why she went straight home.
Shikata arahen kara uchi ga bike de shinryousho ni tsurete tte sono mama ie made okutte kitan ya. Sore kara mata tombo gaeri ya. Meiwaku ya de honma.
I hadn't noticed at all.
Nan ya? Nan de anta ga ochikonderu?
Aitsu no ometsuke yaku o tanonda no wa anta daro.
I started living in this house on the condition that I would look after Misuzu. If I couldn't even accomplish something as simple as that, I would truly be a freeloader.
Kinisurukoto arahen. Anta ni wa mou muri ya.
She waved her hands in front of my face.
Anta mo mita ero? Ano ko wa dareka to chitashiku naru to kansha.
My bad. Let's play that again.
Anta mo mita ero? Ano ko wa dareka to chitashiku naru to kanshaku okosu nya. Ano ka anta ni bettari ya kara na. Kanshaku tomerun wa mo anta ni wa tsutomarahen.
I finally understood what she said. If Misuzu had loved Haruko, then there would be no way they could have been living together until now. Because Haruko wouldn't have been able to stop Misuzu's fits. Oh, what the hell? She doesn't love her mom? Oh! Damn, dude, that's a fucking shocker. I'm not gonna lie. They seem so, I guess, not normal, right? Because her mom's never there. But they didn't seem like they have issues with each other. I thought she still loved her mom. But it, I guess it's for the best. Right, like I said right there. If she loved her mom, then no one can stop her fits. Haruko seemed to know what I was thinking.
Damn,
that's tough, dude. She laughed self-derisively. Damn,
bruh.
She got up unsteadily. I decided to leave her to her own devices. Has Haruko fallen asleep? Or was she usually quiet when she was drinking alone? After I turned off the lights, there was no sound besides the noise of the bugs and the low hum of the fan. But my legs stretched out in the pale moonlight, I got to thinking. Up there, the girl is having the same dream over and over again. The girl is always alone. She fades away before she has the chance to grow up. She keeps dreaming the same sad dream. Those were the words I just remembered today. I didn't even know when exactly I had heard them before. Those words had taken root inside of me as if they were there all along. A girl that had the same dream over and over again. A girl in the sky. Misuzu told me that she kept having dreams of the sky. She was always alone until she met me. She was always behaving like a child. Moreover, it seemed to have seen Misuzu disappear suddenly before. She had looked almost as if she melted into the sky. This couldn't possibly be sheer coincidence. As for the final line, she keeps dreaming the same sad dream. Did that mean that Misuzu would keep dreaming a sad dream? Misuzu did mention something similar. The girl in the sky and Misuzu. There was a chance that they were one and the same. Misuzu continued to dream about the girl in the sky. And supposed that the dream and the girl in the sky had were the same as Misuzu. Misuzu would fade away before she has a chance to grow up. I shrugged off the doubts that were forming in my head. That can't be. Misuzu was not alone. She had Haruko and me. She was always laughing. Laughing so often that I felt like laughing along with her. I closed my eyes. I was probably too tired. My eyelids were wet. The 25th. It was morning. The same scenery greeted us on the way to school.
夏休みの登校って少し寂しいね。
Huh?
だって 他に投稿してる人いないから。そうだな。ねえ。Mizu
looked at me.
どうした?
ジュース買ってもいいかな?
あ、好きにしろ。すごく喉渇いた。
I think she saw me sipping on my drink. She got thirsty. She jumped off the seawall and ran to the vending machine. I had journeyed 1,000 miles, searching, and I finally made it here. Slurp, slurp. I realized that Mizu was looking up at me from the bottom of the seawall while drinking her fruit juice.
何か考え事してる?
She put the straw away from her mouth and asked me.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Perhaps you are the one who I've been searching for all my life. You are the one whom I had earnestly sought, and now you're right here within my reach.
Misuzu.
I reached out my hand to Misuzu.
Huh?
Misuzu placed her hand on mine. I held it. I have found you. You were here all along. I pulled her up onto the seawall.
What?
She was going to fall towards the beach, but I caught her body. Such a small body. I had a sudden dizzy spell. Possibly because of the heat. I let go of Misuzu.
体は大丈夫か?
うん、全然平気。 し、元気なのが取り柄だから。
She turned towards the sea breeze and stretched.
だよな。お前から元気取ったら何も残らないもんな。
それってひどいと思う。
冗談だ。
ユキトさんは少し元気ない？
いや、元気だぞ。いつだって腹さえ減ってなかったら元気なんだ。
ユキトさんらしい。
We turn back to face our own directions.
ねえ、ユキトさん。もしかして、またこの町出ようとか考えてるかな？
そうだな。近いうちにそうなるかもしれない。そもそも長いしすぎた。一箇所に腰を落ち着かせるのは好きじゃないんだ。
それは慣れてないからだと思うな。ずっといたらわかるよ。ここすごくいい町。
まあ、お前みたいなのんきなやつにはぴったりの町だな。
ユキトさんには物足りない？
そうだな。
ユキトさん、いろんなところ旅してきて、いろんなこと経験してきてるんだろうし、物足りないかな。でも私はずっと一人だったからすごく楽しいよ。
どうして？いるだろう、友達の一人や二人。
ううん、いないよ。だって私変な子だから。ユキトさんも知ってるよね。友達になれそうになると私癇癪を起こして泣き出しちゃうの。
She's self-aware。
どうしてかわからないけど、小さい時からずっとそんなだから、みんな私から離れていくの。
She had given up hope on herself. Her detachment from her situation told me that.
そうか。
うん。
でもそれでもお前は一人じゃない、ハルコがいる。
お母さん。
Yeah, that's right. She doesn't love her mom.
お母さんはね、本当のお母さんじゃないから。
Wait, what? Oh my god, what? I turned around to look at Misuzu. She was watching the horizon past the sea.
お母さんは、ハルコさんは本当はおばさん。
おばさん。 Then that's her aunt.
私が変な子だから押し付けられたの。すごく辛かった。だって押し付けられた方に私は迷惑かけるんだもの。ハルコおばさんは嫌がったけど。
Dang, I never realized it though. She never really called her mom, right?
ハルコおばさんは嫌がったけど。
ハルコおばさん。Did she ever call her mom? I never realized that.
結局私はここで暮らすことになった。でも、ハルコさんには自分の生活があったから。一つ屋根の下だけど、別々に暮らしてるの。私、本当に邪魔者だから。
Nah, bro, she love you, bro. That's why she took you to the clinic and stuff.
ずっと、ハルコおばさんにも迷惑かけ続けてる。だから、何も言わない。贅沢とか。迷惑かけないように、一人で遊んでたの。一人で変なジュース探したり、トランプして。
Dang, bro, what the hell? How can she smile like this? Dang, she got a sad life. I didn't bother to wipe off my dripping sweat. I just stood there. I could see the sky behind Misuzu. It was always so far away.
Misuzu, お前はこの空にいるんだろう。
I said, words that I couldn't comprehend.
だったら、ユキトさんはどうする？私と友達になってくれるのかな？
Misuzu smiled shyly. The wind picked up. The bell rang.
あ、行かないと。じゃあね、ユキトさん。あ、これ持って行ったらダメなんだ。
She walked over to me, handing me her almost empty packet of fruit juice.
お昼一緒に食べようね。
She jumped off the seawall and ran off. I looked up at the blue sky. Since a long, long time ago, the girl was up there, having the same dream over and over again. The girl is always alone. She fades away before she has a chance to grow up. She keeps dreaming the same sad dream. It was an ordinary day in summer. In the morning, I took a nap on the seawall under the light of the sun. Afterwards, I went home with Misuzu and ate lunch. In the afternoon, I did my puppet act. The shopping district was deserted. I wasn't able to control my puppet well. There were too many things for me to think about, and evening arrived quickly. I kept my puppet in my pocket and stood up. I had the feeling that I had been doing this for a long time. It was finally time for dinner. I was still thinking. Just one thing. I'll ask Misuzu just one thing. I believe that would give me the answer I need.
食べ終わったら散歩に行かないか?
ん? 散歩?
いや、お前に行く気があるんならだけどな。
She put down her chopsticks and looked at me.
ユキトさんから誘ってくれるなんてすごく意外。
Misuzu laughed.
ホタルいないかな? ホタル。
Hotaru? That's what Hotaru mean, fireflies.
お尻がピカって光ってて、かわいいホタル。
Maybe I seen it wrong. I don't wanna cause trouble.
ユキトさんはホタルとは友達じゃないのかな?
お尻。 She chatted as she walked. I walked slowly after her.
なあ、ミスズ。
I called her.
一つだけ思い出してほしい。
いいよ。 何かな?
She turned towards me.
えっとだな。
On seeing her innocent face, I found it hard to speak. I looked away. The seawall was in front of me. The open sea lay beyond it. Beyond it, the sound of the waves were coming from that direction.
明日は海に来ようか。
It wasn't that I had originally intended to ask.
本当?
Her expression changed, and she grabbed my wrist. Her face came closer to me.
ああ、そういうのもいいかと思ってさ。うんうん、すごくいい。
Now that I recall, she had asked me to go to the beach with her during the first time we met. Oh yeah! She looked elated. She ran off with a skipping motion. I had given her something to look forward to. In exchange, I wanted her to recall something.
なあ、ミス。夢の中のお前には翼があるか?
I finally asked the important question.
翼?
Mizu turned around.
夢の中で、お前は空を飛んでるんだろう?
あ、そうだね。
She probably hadn't considered that question before.
でも、自分に翼があるかなんて考えたことないよ。
そっか。もういい。
うん。でも、どうしてそんなこと聞いたのかな?
いや、なんでもない。
ユキト さん? ん? 何か考え事してるのかな?
あ、ああ。
Mizu's voice called me back to reality.
行こうな、明日。海。
うん。じゃあ、今日はもう帰るか。 そうだね。
Mizu took a deep breath and exhaled.
明日楽しみ。
She smiled. Oh, Umi! You're the beach episode's here! I woke up to silence. The living room of the Kamio residence looked the same as it always had been. I heard the chipping of the cicadas and the whirling of the fan. Other than those sounds, it was completely silent. Mizu would usually be up and about by now. I turned over on the tatami mat. My back felt as if there was something heavy hanging off of it. I got up, stood on my tippy toes, and stretched. I came to Misuzu.
Misuzu, 入るぞ.
I slid the door open and entered. Misuzu had both legs stretched out on the bed. She was massaging them.
どうしたのかな? なかなか元に戻らないな。
Damn, bro, what the fuck? On the beach episode? When we finally go into the beach? That's what she wanted to go in the first place.
どうしたんだ?
足がしびれたみたいになってる。
What? She watched her own feet with wonder.
昨日歩きすぎたんだろ。
そんなことないと思う。この頃、朝はだいたいこんな感じだから。前からたまにあったけど、いつもはすぐに治るの。
Dang.
ただの低血圧なんじゃないのか?
にゃは、そうかも。
She massaged her legs again.
ん?何か言った?
いや。
お腹空いたのかな?朝ごはん、ちょっと待っててね。すぐ歩けるようになると思うから。
朝飯はいいから寝てろ。
でも、学校は行かないと。それまでに良くなるかな。
無理すんなよな。
私ね、遅刻は多いけど、欠席はしないんだよ。
そらいい子だな。
うん、ちょっといい子。だからね、頑張っていく。
そっか、すぐに良くなるさ。
うん、良くなるよ。
The second hand on the clock was ticking away. Misuzu massaged her legs quietly. I could see her getting worried. She finally realized the severity of her condition.
どうする?病院行くか?
ううん、大丈夫。もう少し休ませてね。
In the end, classes had begun, but Misuzu's legs had not gotten better.
授業始まっちゃった。
もう気にするな。行ける状況じゃない。
そうだね。残念。
一日ぐらい行かなくても大して変わらないだろ。今日は寝てろ。
でも、お昼ご飯。
その辺のものを勝手に食べるから、心配するな。
そうしてくれると嬉しい。
She looked down at her chest and said in an uneasy voice.
本当は、ちょっと食欲ないかも。
夏風邪だろ。変なジュースばかり飲むからだ。
それは関係ないと思う。
Damn, bruh. This is fucked up. What's with fucking Junmai today, bruh? He's always making the main girl dying for some reason. Canon, the main girl dying. Air, she's dying right now. Clannad, she died. Little Busters, she was kind of dying. Well, technically, everybody was dying.
じゃあな。おとなしくしてろよ。
Damn, Jermaine, what the fuck, bruh? He's always trying to kill somebody. Why is he like this? I left the room. I went to the kitchen and drank a glass of water. Always dead. I sighed. My body felt strangely tired. Damn, bro. Why didn't you tell me the truth? She do love Misuzu. She called her mom.Haruko appeared. Damn, she lied to us the entire time. She told us she was her mom. She pushed me aside. She entered the kitchen, took out the carton of milk from the fridge, and drank from it. This mother was still living life her own way.
またまごっつ痛いわ。久々やわ、二日酔いやなんて。でも仕事や。一家の生計立てるために頑張らんとな。
Damn, did we tell her? If we tell her, she's not gonna go to work. She gotta support the family. And you know we can't make income. We're broke.
貧乏暇なしや。
We can't tell her. Lips are sealed.
なんやねん。
Don't tell her. She turned to face
me. 美鈴を見てやってくれ。
ん?どないしたあの子。
具合が悪いんだ。
あれやな、落ちてるもんでも拾ってくたんやろ。
She would do something like that.
小さい時もかりんとうと間違えて変なもの食べそうになった子や。口に入れる直前で叩き落としたったから無事やったけどな。あの子ほんまにそそっかしいわ。
And she really do act like her mom too. After...Having only milk for breakfast, she returned to the living room.
そしたら、うち昼まで寝るから、あとよろしくな。
顔ぐらい出してやれよ。
頭痛いね、うち。病人が二人顔を突き合わせても気がめいるだけやろ。それに、あの子も今更そんなんで元気出へん。あんたがそばにおったったらそれでいいやろ。ほな、おやすみ。
She disappeared down the corridor. Then he never told her her legs are numb. But I think it's for the best anyway. Well, Haruko said bothered me. Does it matter when she has you? I noticed that my fists were clenched. What was I mad about? Why was I flustered? I recall it just now, when I was with Misuzu. It was just a summer cold. She'd get better with a bit of rest. But a feeling of dread was building up inside me. Excuse me. The branches were swaying outside the lattice window. Beyond that was a patchwork of blue sky. Summer marched on, just like I had always done. There was no sign of sadness to be found. Misuzu sat up and began laying out on the cards of her lap.
トランプ。
お前さ、休んだんだからって遊んでないで、少しは寝たらどうなんだ。
Damn, bro.
一日中遊んでられる。嬉しい。
Yeah, she's so sweet too, though. It's hard to be mad at her.
だったら休んだ意味がないだろ。
だって、眠りたくないもん。
She stopped gathering the cards.
どうしてだ。
今朝の夢、変だったから。
空の夢じゃなかったのか。
うん。
Her face clouded over with doubt.
空の夢だったけど、今までと全然違った。
Mizu's eyes trembled as she tried to recall her dream.
ぽっかりと月が浮かんでて、すごく明るかった。私、空に登ろうとしてた。体中がズキズキ痛くて動かないのに、ずっと高くまで登ろうとしてた。そしたら、声が聞こえてきたの。
声？
たくさんの人の声。私、それで分かった。みんなが私を閉じ込めようとしてるって。耳の中がワンワンなって、それ以上登れなくなって。それで。
And then she said nothing else. It was a dream of the sky which sounded similar to the previous one, but was actually different. Even though she was done describing her dream, she still looked worried. She looked as though she could still hear those voices.
もう見たくないの？
ただの夢だろ。気にするな。
I patted her head.
うん。それじゃ気にしないね。
ああ。しっかり休め。
うん。
She nodded and reached for the cards again.
お前な。
Soon there was only the sound of Mizu laying out cards. I kept thinking about what I should do.A long time had passed. I realized that I had become completely silent. I looked at Misuzu. She had dozed off with the card still on her lap. Is she having a dream now? In the beginning, it was a dream of the sky. Misuzu had noticed that the sky was filled with sadness. Last night, the dream had taken on another form. Misuzu had once said that time was going backwards in her dreams. What did it mean if the dream took on a sudden change?What kind of dream would Misuzu have next? Misuzu's head moved. She was awake. She looked around and saw me.
私、寝てたんだ。
夢、見なかったか?
She stared at me with sleepy eyes.
うん、いなかった。
そうか。
Oh. Misuzu stretched herself.
よしと。
Oh, can she stand? She probably began to collect the cards.
ゆきとさん、暇って…だよね。
ん？なんかあるのか？
うん。海行こうと思って。
海。
そっか。そうだったな。
I promised to take her there. But could Misuzu go in her current condition?
浜辺で遊ぶの。砂を掘ったり、波から逃げたりしながら。
俺もか？
いいよ。ユキトさん見ていてくれるだけでも。
いや、いいよ。約束だからな。
本当？嬉しい。
She smiled broadly, but I mean, I hadn't seen that smile in a long time. She was most lovable when she smiled like that, without a care in the world. I wanted to see her smile forever.
But...
Dang. I didn't want Mizu to overexert herself.
Damn, that's
one of her catchphrases. Yeah, dot dot dot. You're right. She always said that a lot. I notice. There's always a... Every girl, at least in old Key Studio, I feel like they always have a catchphrase a little bit. Hey. I think it's Misuzu catchphrase. Yeah, you're right. So done it, or some shit like that, right?
Ja, ashita iko ne.
Ah? So naru youni ganbare.
It's a pretty sad phrase, though. That means she's used to being disappointed, right? Yeah, you're right. Her catchphrase is disappointment. Cause she's used to it, bruh. That's pretty sad. Misuzu only smiled when she talked about going to the sea. In the end, Misuzu was in bed all day. Her condition remained unchanged. The house was deathly quiet. If only Haruko were here to liven up the mood. There wasn't anyone to make dinner. When I asked Misuzu about it, she told me she didn't have an appetite. I also didn't feel like eating myself. I spent my time looking for a way to quell the feeling of unease that was haunting me. Haruko came back after midnight. She was staggering drunk, as habit predicted. This woman was hopeless when she was drunk. I finally understood that about her.
Ora, Miyagi-ya.
She had a sushi box in her hand.
今から飲みながら食うで? Huh? Misuzu-chin-wa-monete-shimotan-ka? Shaa-nai. 2人で食うで、サラダしや!
1人で食ってくれ。
なんや、付き合い悪いやんか。 一緒に食おうや。 美味しいやで、ここの寿司。
食わない。
なんでそないなこと言うねん。 1人より2人で食べた方が美味しいや。 お酒飲みながらつつこ。
I didn't know what I would say to her if I continued to stay here. What insults would I hurl at her? Tell her, bro! Misuzu dying, bro! You gotta tell her. I was scared because she gotta provide for the family, but fuck it, bro. She needs you. She held my hand. But I flung her hand away. I know the truth. Misuzu told me. You're not her mother. You're her aunt.
どうして Misuzu を引き取ってしまったんだよ?なんや。あの子話してたんかいな。引き取ったんやない。押し付けられたんや。
いやいや言うてんけどな。そのせいで、あいつあんたに甘えられないんだろ。うちなんかに甘えたいわけあらへん、あの子が。うち、ほんまの親やないから。そんなの関係ないだろ。あいつにとっての親は、あの日からあんた一人だけなんだよ。自覚しろ。
Haruko sighed and scratched her head. Usually I would say it's never too late, but she kinda right. It's kinda too late, to be honest.
あの日から何年経ってる思うんや?もう時間が経ちすぎとる。何も取り返すことなんてできへんのや。
Damn, I don't know how to respond to that. She disappeared into the kitchen. I had nothing more to say to her, so I didn't give chase. He didn't know what to say too. She got a point. It is kind of too late. Cause, It's been years, bro. Decades. Having lost my place, I left the room. The narrow hallway felt strangely empty. I decided to go cool my head. I went to the entranceway and put on my shoes. In order to avoid drawing attention, I opened the door softly. The countryside town at night was devoid of people. The night air was warm and stagnant. The air in the house felt cooler. I walked aimlessly until I reached the coast. Then I kept on walking. This was the place I ended up at. I climbed the steps of the seawall and sat down. I could hear the sound of the waves. The sandy beach was setting in front of the sea. Waves broke relentlessly on the shore before they were absorbed by the sand. I thought about the Kamio residence. Just a small home in a seaside town. I had traveled with my mother ever since I was still a child. A home with family warmth was what I always yearned for. But in this home lived only the jaded. Mizu and Hanako has always kept a distance between themselves. They had lived in their lives like this thus far. I closed my eyes and listened to the waves. The sound repeated forever. I listened to the voice in my head. Words bubbled the recesses of my mind. Hey, who's that? I don't think I know this voice. That wasn't Misuzu's voice. It was a familiar voice I heard as a child. His mom!
でも、連れて行ってあげられなかった。やりたいことがたくさんあったの。でも、何一つしてあげられなかった。夏はまだ始まったばかりなのに、知っていたのに。
The voice uttered each word surely and carefully. I couldn't understand some of the words that were being said, but I had listened with full concentration, because I understood that the voice was trying to tell me something important. It's not his mom. If that was his mom, he would have said his mom. I don't know who this is, but she sounded important. That's Misuzu!
それから、ある恥の痛みを感じるようになる。そして、女の子は、すべてを忘れる。一番大切な人のことさえ、思い出せなくなる。そして、最後の夢を見終わった朝、女の子は、死んでしまう。Damn!
Fucking John Mayday! He always do this shit! He's always killing the main heroine for no reason. I wouldn't say no reason, but damn, bro, why you always gotta kill her? She can't be saved. No matter what, if Jun Mighty's evolved, you better bet the main girl is always gonna die. He even did that in animes, right? Technically, Angel Beats, the main girl died, technically, right? And freaking... This newest anime, bro. Or the day I became God. Right? That's a Jun Maiden one, right? I don't remember who wrote that. But, I mean, technically, the main girl almost pretty much dead, right? I don't know who did Charlotte either. I think that's Key Studio 2, though. But it was the... I'm just saying all the spoilers. My bad. But you should have been doing this. Damn, bruh. She seemed to be holding back her emotions. Oh.
だからその子はずっと一人ぼっち。二人の心が近づけば、二人とも病んでしまう。二人とも助からない。だから、その子は言ってくれたの。私から離れて。 優しくて
とても強い子だったの。だから、ユキト、今度こそ、あなたが救ってほしいの。
Damn, that is his mom.
その子を救えるのは、あなただけなのだから。
I woke up. It seems that I dozed off for a while.
夢だったのか。
That voice was my mother's voice. I remembered. I had that same conversation with my mother before. But when was that? I couldn't recall. Although it was a long time ago, it felt as if it had only happened recently.
女の子は夢を見るの。最初は空の夢。夢はだんだん昔へと遡っていく。
Then I recall that Misuzu had said something, the same thing.She said that time in her dreams was going backwards. She could tell by the movement in the air and the smell.
まるで、ミスズみたいだな。
While I was considering the implication, I felt a mental fissure running through my mind, head. More words flooded into my mind.
その夢が、女の子を蝕んでいくの。最初は、だんだん体が動かなくなる。
That happened to Misuzu.She said her legs were numb. Suppose that my mother was talking about Misuzu. Then the next thing that would happen.
それから、あるはずのない痛みを感じるようになる。そして、女の子は、すべてを忘れていく。一番大切な人のことさえ、思い出せなくなる。そして、最後の夢を見終わった朝、女の子は、死んでしまう。
Damn, bro. No, that was impossible. My mother had to be talking about the girl in the sky. My mother couldn't have known about Misuzu. And yet, what she said described Misuzu's condition perfectly. It was like a prophecy.
どういうことだ?
I asked myself in the darkness. I desperately tried to reel in my memories. Why would I remember these things? Why would my mother tell me all that?But I was certain my mother had told me this.
Yukito, 今度こそあなたが救ってほしいの。その子を救えるのはあなただけなのだから。
I could still remember the look in her eyes and the sound of her voice when she said that. However, I had no idea how to save Misuzu. I stood up and looked into the darkness. The sound of the waves persisted. The sea was that way.This town was so close to the sea that nobody living here would give the sea its passing glance.
海に行きたいってその子は言ったの。でも連れて行ってあげられなかった。
I'm going to take Misuzu to the sea. That should be an easy thing to do. The sea has to be the answer, right? I woke up. The dusty ceiling greeted me.I ended up sleeping in a shed last night. It was hard for me to go back to the house. The cicadas were noisy in the morning, as per usual. Did Misuzu have a good night's sleep? I sat up. Then I recalled those words.
女の子は夢を見るの。最初は空の夢。夢はだんだん昔へと遡っていく。でもね、その夢が女の子を蝕んでいくの。
I shook my head to forget about that. It was no use. That voice had begun to burn into my mind. Suddenly, I heard another noise. Somebody was opening the main door. Is it Misuzu? Was she going so early in the morning? I went outside the shed. Haruko, right? I circled to the front of the porch.
Huh?
Yeah. Remember, bruh, Misuzu can't walk.It was Haruko.
なんや、起きとったんかいな。
あんたこそ、仕事は午後からじゃなかったのか。
仕事はしばらく休むことにしたんや。
I looked down to see what Haruko was holding. It was a bag too big for simply shopping.
なんだそれ。
旅行カバンや。
Traveling bag?
旅行？
ふらり一人旅や。
What?
どこへ？
温泉巡りや。
I don't know, man. I feel like she cares, but I think she's lying to us.
マジか。
ええー、温泉が餃子あんねん。温泉使って酒飲んでゆっくりすんねん。
This woman, does she know what sort of condition Mizu's in right now? Mizu was in bed all day yesterday.
何考えてんだあんたは。
I was more exasperated than angry.
なんや、文句あるんか。うちの勝手や。
あいつは、ミスズはどうするんだよ。
あんたに任せる。あんた、やるときはやるし、案外しっかりしとる。ミスズもあんたのこと好いとる。
Dang. I don't know if that's a compliment or... what?
せやから、うちがおらん間はあんたが面倒見たってや。
Maybe. I want to give her the benefit of the doubt. Maybe being around Misuzu is too hard for her, right? She'll get heartbroken if she sees Misuzu in that condition. Maybe that's why she's saying this. She want to rely on Yukito to save her. But she can't look at Misuzu. It'll break her heart. That's what I'm going with in my head until they explain it in the story.I want to give her the benefit of the doubt.
夢を見ている。
I started talking about things I didn't fully understand.
その夢がミスズをこんな風にしてるんだ。
はあ？いきなり何言い出すね。
そのうちにミスズはあるはずのない痛みを感じるようになる。それからミスズは忘れていく。俺のこともあんたのこともな。最後の夢を見終わった朝、多分ミスズは死んでしまう。
What I said sounded too surreal. Haruko's expression changed instantly.
あんたな、言うてええ冗談と悪い冗談があるで。うちにはうちの事情があんねん。あんたのたわごと聞いとる暇ない。
娘を置いて温泉に行くのがあんたの事情か。
ミスズはうちの娘やあらへん。
Damn, bruh
だから行くんやないか。
Aw, man. But look at her face though, bruh. She's just not being honest. Right? She did tell us the truth. But it's like many layers to that.
だから行くんやないか。
Just because Misu wasn't her own flesh and blood, I finally remembered. This woman had no responsibilities of a parent to begin with. Further talking was pointless.
ほな、うち行くわ。
She turned and walked away and watched her go. After she disappeared from sight, I looked up at the sky. There was not a single cloud. Today was going to be another hot day. When I returned to Misuzu's room, her blanket was lying on her bed like a husk.
Misuzu?
I walked out into the hallway to find her.Mizu was standing in the kitchen.
もういいのか、お前。
うん、大丈夫。
Yeah, I don't know, man.
それに、朝食作らないと、誰かさんがお腹グーグー空かせちゃうし。
Her face still looked pale. It was clear that she was pushing herself.
お前寝てろよ。俺が作る。
いいって。それに、こういうことしてないと、本当に病人になっちゃったみたいだし。
Oh, man.You are sick, though.
そうか。
うん。
I heard the sound of Mizu using the chopping knife. Although she didn't to be any good at academics, she seemed pretty good at housework. I felt that that was better than those who were the reverse. I watched her back intently while waiting for the right moment to speak. Better to say here and now rather than at the dining table later.
そうや。ハルコが出かけていった。しばらく家を留守にするらしいぞ。
うん、知ってる。
なんだ。
Had Haruko told her about it?
私、お母さん大好き。
Damn, bro, which one though?
そうか。
Oh, there's so much layers! When she said she loved her mom, which mom? I decided to avoid the subject. That's a good idea, I guess. Finally, the cooking was done.We had spaghetti and meat sauce and the usual sunny side up eggs. It's spaghetti for breakfast. Mizu Play had only half the amount of food as mine. Even then, she still had trouble finishing her food.
Misuzu, wakeiteru ka?
I said in a soft voice and peered inside the room. I heard a sound like the flapping of the bird's wings. I slipped open the door and went in. Mizu was shuffling the deck of cards.
Neteiro tte itta daro.
Sakki made neteta kara.
She continued laying the cards out.
Mata henna ime mita no ka?
Uun. Ii yume datta.
Sora no yume ka?
Uun. Kondo wa yoru no mori.
She turned to face me.
Mori no naka de hanashi o shiteru no.
Daru to?
Yoku oboete nai kedo, sugu chikaku ni dareka ga yorisotte kurete ta. Atashi sono hito ni umi tte nanda tte kiita. Soshitara oshiete kureta no. Umi no koto takusan. Hanashiteru dake de sugoku tanoshikatta. Kotoba o zenbu tsutsunde itsu made mo shimatte okitai tte omotta gurai. Sono gurai shiawase datta.
Mizu lowered her gaze. She looked as though she was still within the dream.
Anna yume nara motto mitai na.
Nara netero yo.
Datte mottai nai yo. Kitto natsu wa mijikai kara.
While she was telling me all that, I had my mind on something else.
Onna no ko wa yume o miru no. Saisho wa sora no yume. Yume wa dandan mukashi e to sakanobotte iku. Sono yume ga onna no ko o mushibande iku no.
Yukito-san, kowai kao.
Ore wa itsu demo konna kao da zo.
Nya, sou da ne. Sore ja otonashiku neru ne. Hontou wa mada chotto karada ga darui kanji da shi.
She collected the cards on the floor one by one. Her movements looked sluggish, and so I told her.
Umi ni iko.
Mizu looked at me with surprise.
Yukito-san, itteru koto hen. Nero tte ittari, asobi ni iko tte ittari.
Ki ga kawatta nda. Kino ikenakatta doro.
Demo.
She looked uncertain.
Ikitai ndaro? Mada hi mo hayai shi.
She looked relieved upon hearing that. She nodded with a smile.
それじゃ、外で待ってるな.
Then we should be okay. I went out into the hallway. As soon as I was alone, the voice came back to me.
闇始めてしまえば、それから先は早かった. 夏はまだ始まったばかりなのに。
And so I told myself, I'll definitely take Mizu to the beach. Surely I can do that. Surely I'm able to.
Iko?
Ah.
Soreja, shuppatsu!
Shuppatsu. We had the same conversation yesterday. But as soon as I stepped outside, I regretted what I was doing. The afternoon sun was fierce. It was so hot that the concrete road might melt. Mizu walked one step at a time.
Yukkuri de ii kara na. Muri sunna yo.
Dang, dude, can we get her a wheelchair or something? She flashed a V sign to show her determination. Her forehead was already covered with sweat. When we got to the first corner, Mizu stopped walking.
Chotto matte.
Oh.
Was she this weekend? I let her in my shoulder. I put Mizu's arm around my neck.
Gomen ne.
We started walking again. The sun was shining mercilessly on us. Mizu was leaning on me. Her burning hot body felt so small. How far can this petite body go? The heated air shimmered on the road. Our journey seemed to go on forever. Is the sea really that far away?
Daijoubu ka?
Daijoubu.
I put my hand around Mizu's shoulder. I tried to support her weight. Then... Mizu looked at me with eyes that were trying to tell me something. Her eyes became wet. Tears flowing down her cheeks.
ごめんね.
No, she's throwing a fit.
すぐに治るから.
Oh, no, 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 no. I thought she was doing a fit. Her legs are just gone. Damn, dude. She's too sick. Her smile became contorted. Then I realized what I had done. I had gotten too close to her. Damn. Damn, bro. There was no stopping her fit now. Yeah, she is having a fit now. Mizu brushed off my arm and started crying. But this was no fit. It was something else. Something unknown. Our journey was over. There was nothing I could do but wait for Mizu to stop crying. The clear sunny sky was hanging over our heads. But an ominous feeling was building up inside me. How far can we walk tomorrow? Will we get closer to the beach than today? Or will we stop further away? The sun was setting. Time and tide waits for no man. Whether that was for better or worse, I did not know.
No,
I should have done this from the very start. I couldn't help but think that. But Mizu did not say anything more. I stood up. Plant, plant. Mizu was playing cards by herself. Her slender fingers went through the same motions. She did it over and over again, never becoming bored of it. I became aware that Mizu was looking at me. She said all of a sudden.
Yukito-san が探してる人と私の夢関係あるんだよね?
She knows, bro.
さあな。関係ないんじゃないか?
だってこの前私に聞いたよね。夢の中の私に翼があるかって。
あんなもの冗談だ。忘れろ。
うん。Yukito-san真剣な目してたよ。ねえ、教えてほしい。
Mizu was close to me, watching me intently. Her gaze was honest and full of determination. I closed my eyes. Up in the sky, there's a girl with wings. She had been there since long ago. She is there, even now. In the same air, she continues to feel the wind with her widespread wings. I had been told those poetic phrases ever since I was a kid. And now I knew the continuation. Up there, the girl is having the same dream over and over again. The girl is always alone. She fades away before she has a chance to grow up. She keeps dreaming the same sad dream. There were the prophecies from my mother.
それからだんだん体が動かなくなる。あるはずのない痛みを感じるようになる。夏はまだ始まったばかりなのに、知っていたのに、私は何もできなかった。
Combining the two parts, they could only mean one thing. However, I did not wish to acknowledge the truth.
これは私がいろいろ考えてたどり着いた答え。聞いてくれる?
ああ。
私の夢はもう一人の私なの。その子には翼があって、きっと自由に空が飛べた。それなのに、今その子は苦しんでいるの。だから私に何かを伝えようとしてる。だから私頑張って夢を見る。もっと夢を見ればわかるかもしれないから、その子がどうして苦しんでるのか。そうすれば、その子のこと助けてあげられるかもしれない。
Her usual smile appeared on her face.
いい考え。ナイスアイデア。そうしようっと。おやすみ。
おやすみ。She covered her head with the futon. I pulled the futon off.
バカ!
いや、私、バカだから。
なあ、ミスズ。
I chose my words carefully.
お前の言ってることは、正しいのかもしれない。 でもな、夢の中のお前が苦しんでいるとしたら、このまま夢を見続けたら、お前もそいつと同じことになるかもしれない。
Up in the sky, there's a girl with wings. In the same air, she continues to feel the wind with her widespread wings. That was no longer a vague image. That girl is suffering in the sky. Ever since eons ago, I had come to save that girl, and yet I had no idea what to do.
Yukito-san, 私が夢を見始めたのはきっと偶然じゃないんだよね。
She studied my face. I couldn't answer her.
私、今年の夏は特別だって思った。頑張って友達を作ろうって思ってた。そうしたら、ユキトさんに会えた。
And she did it.
そうして、夢を見始めた。きっと全部一つにつながってるんだよね。だから、頑張りたいな。この夏を一番幸せにしたいから。ユキトさんと出会えた夏だから。
Oh, dang! Misuzu looked at me. Her eyes were free from doubt. How should I answer her?
わかった。
You gotta let her keep going. I answered her.
俺が手伝ってやるから。
うん。
もう寝るぞ。お前も寝ろ。
女の子は夢を見るの。最初は空の夢。夢はだんだん昔へと遡っていく。その夢が女の子を蝕んでいくの。
If that was true, how could I stop it? There was no way I could stop Misuzu from having dreams. Is there really nothing I could do? I kept searching for an answer. Then the next day. So the next one's forgetfulness, right? It was morning. I was in Misuzu's room. Misuzu was on her bed, hugging her knees. Her cheeks and eyes were red. She had been crying.
Misuzu.
I wanted to rush to her side, but I hesitated to do so. If I touch her, would I set off her fit again?
違うの。
Misuzu shook her head. Understood the reason then.
夢を見たのか。
うん。
She nodded.
悲しかったの。何度やってもうまくいかなかった。もう時間がないのに。やり遂げなければいけないのに。それなのに、どうしてもうまくいかなかった。
Misuzu laid down and covered her face with her blanket. She was stifling her sobs. I didn't have any idea what kind of dream Misuzu was having, but I knew that the dreams were eating away at her, and yet there was nothing I could do for her. When I was aware of my surroundings again, Misuzu was already asleep. She was worn out from all the crying. I sat down and leaned against the wall. Misuzu's long hair rose and fell in rhythm with her breathing.
San.Yukito-san, Yukito-san.
Opened my eyes to find that it was already sunset. Misuzu was there. She was still in her pajamas and sitting up on the bed.
起きてたのか?
Yukito-san, すごくよく寝てた。もう起きないかと思った。
そんなわけないだろ。
I prodded her head lightly and she smiled back at me.
また夢を見たの。今度はね。ちょっと楽しい夢、ちょっと楽しくて、ちょっと悲しい夢。
なんだよそれ。
夜なのに空がすごく明るいの。音楽と笑い声が聞こえて、たくさんの人が輪になって踊ってた。あれ、きっとお祭りだった。みんなすごく楽しそう。でも、私は…それを遠くから見てる。あそこは私の場所じゃないって。
知ってたから。She didn't mention this is going to be a summer festival. I think that might be the key, right? The beach and the summer festival. She mentioned there was a summer festival earlier in the visual novel. It's when we were both at the shrine. And I think it was during Mizuzu's birthday. She mentioned it was the summer festival. She paused and looked about the room.
Omatsuri. Atashi mo ikitai na. Demo, chotto muri da ne.
Hey.
Tabun, omatsuri wa tou sugiru kara.
She spoke as if it were a certainty.
Omae na. Yume no naka de gurai motto sekkyokuteki ni naru yo. Tomodachi wo tsukuru toka.
Tomodachi?
She cocked her head and looked at me.
Tomodachi, iru kara.
Doko ni?
Tomodachi. Yukito-san, tomodachi.
Ore wa tomodachi toyu yori, nan nan daro na?
Damn, what am I? I didn't know myself.
Demo, Yukito-san, nice idea. Tsugi no yume de tameshite miru ne.
Tomodachi. She laughed, and our conversation came to a halt.
Yukito-san, ii kana?
Ah, nanda?
Yappari, umi ni ikitai.
I looked out the window. The crimson sky was peeking in from the treetops.
Ima kara ka?
We might not reach the beach by sunset. Even if we go there, it might already be too dark to see anything. But I answered.
Iko.
Sore ja, kigaeru ne.
She tried to get off the bed.
Are?
Oh fuck! Damn, bruh! Mizu fell flat on her face under the tamime. She looked like a puppet being hurled onto the floor.
Hanabutsukechatta.
She tried to get up.
Are? Doushichatta no kana? Ashi ga omokanai na.
Misuzu.
Demo, naoru yo ne.
She massaged her legs. She looked so feeble, it was painful to watch.
Sugu ni wa naoranai kana?
She massaged her legs desperately. I went over to Misuzu. And it held her shoulders.
海になんていつだって行けるさ。今日は休んでろ。な。
ダメ。
Damn, bro, get a wheelchair.
今日は遊ぶって決めたの。
Mizu was more stubborn than usual.
トランプしよう。ユキトさんとトランプ。
She reached out for the pack of cards placed on the table.
届かない。
I let Mizu's body.
あ。
She felt as light as a bird. I put her back on the bed.
頼むから無理しないでくれ。
無理なんかしてないよ。
She tried to get off the bed again.
宿題全然やってない。数学と英語と。
そんなことしてたら、治るものも治らなくなるぞ。
ユキトさん、ちょっと意地悪。そうだ。絵日記つけないと。
明日やればいいだろ。
絵日記は貯めたらダメ。天気とかわからなくなるから。
Damn, bro, you gotta let her write the diary. Remember what your mom said. She's gonna forget.
それに、昨日の分まだ書いてないし。
She looked at me with pleading eyes. I nodded.
どこにあるんだ？俺が取ってやる。
机の引き出し。
Opened the drawer and took out the notebook. Then I flipped to a random page. The plain page was filled with drawings made with color pencils. It looks like a kid's homework.
他人の日記見たらダメ。
本当にちゃんと書いてたのか。
今、意外そうな顔した。
I ignored her and flipped the page. I searched for a puppet of Yukito-san. I watched TV with Yukito-san.I drank fruit juice with Yukito-san. I did homework with Yukito-san. I caught a stag beetle with Yukito-san. With Yukito-san. In these days, which meant something only to Misuzu, my name would always be in them. She concluded each and every day with a sentence and had a lot of fun. Oh, damn! I turned to the last written page. July 27th. Below the date, there was only one line. Today,Yukito-san. The scrawly handwritten abruptly ended there. Most likely, Mizuzu had tried to write into her diary, but she had to give up. She probably had a fit late in the night without my knowing.
ちょっとって言ったのに.
I closed the notebook and handed it to Misuzu.
面白くなかったぞ.
そうかな. 自信作なんだけどな. クラスの自由課題で 一番楽しいの.
こんなにユキトさんって書いてあったら 先生に見せられないだろ.
ここ.
She flipped open the diary and pointed.
Misuzu and Yukito-san.
Oh! She smiled proudly.
いいか. はっきり言ってお前には日記を書く才能がない. だから これからはお前がやったことじゃなく やりたいことを書け.
それ日記じゃない。
いや、日記だ。 書いたことは全部俺が叶えてやるから。
For a long while, Misuzu looked at me. And then she nodded.
色鉛筆欲しい。
I took the pencil stand from the desk. From among the colorful pencils, I selected one with a bright color.
それじゃ、書くね。 まずね、 海に行きたい。
Dang! I remember that in the beginning. She tried to touch the crow, but she always messed up.
変なジュースもっといっぱい飲みたい. お祭りにも行きたいし. それから.
There was a scratching sound, the pencil moving over the paper. Misuzu's dreams were taking form on the white pages. The 29th. It was morning. I woke up while I was trying to turn in my sleep. My back was still hurting. Blinding light was entering through the screen door. Today looked like another hot day. I stood up and headed for Misuzu's room. Gently, I opened the sliding door. Misuzu was still sleeping. Her chest rose and fell with her breathing. She must have been having a dream again. I quietly closed the door and headed for the porch. Our daily lives had taken a drastic change. We stopped going to school in the morning. The rowdy drinking party every night had ceased. Even if I stood outside like this, Misuzu wouldn't run up to me. She could only lie in bed now. I thought about Misuzu's diary. It was filled with her plans for the summer. There were many things that she wanted to do. She should have done all those things. She couldn't even do a single one. I started walking. I reached the shopping district. I took up the position at my usual spot and placed my puppet on the ground. Several kids walked past on the opposite side of the street. They were probably on their way to the pool. I heard their laughter. The summer belonged to them. I looked around. My eyes found the Kitashima Clinic signboard. That doctor would listen to what I had to say. I should have asked her for advice, but I already understood. Mizu's condition was beyond science. She was being trapped by something that shouldn't be there. In that case, I was the only one who could save her. When I came back to my senses, the kid had already disappeared. I infused my will into my puppet. Taro, taro, taro. My puppet walked on the deserted road. The surroundings became darker. All of a sudden, I looked up and saw a huge cumulonimbus cloud covering the sky. Somewhere, there was a place not visible from here. Misuzu was there, alone at this moment. From the ground, everything up there looks like a pipe dream. The truth could not be learned here. The sky that went on forever existed only inside Misuzu. She was wandering among the clouds by herself. I pulled my eyes away and saw my puppet laying on the ground a good distance away.
おかえりなさい.
It was a room I already used to seeing. Misuzu was on the bed laying out the cards.
わ、ゆきとさん汗でびっしょり.
今日も暑いからな. こんな日に外なんて出るもんじゃない.
そうだね.
She laughed softly, but I could see she was suffering.
体動かせないのか?
動かせることは動かせるけど、遠出は無理かな。だから、 海はまたお預け。ふう。
She stopped laying out the cards.
それじゃ、始めるね。
何を？
ミスズチンの夢語りコーナー。今朝見たのは、旅の夢。
That's one thing she got from her auntie, right? Her auntie did this in the beginning of the visual novel. Right? Romance Corner, or something like that.
Misuzu chin no yumegatari corner.
See, she got that from her auntie, or her current mom.
Kesa mita no wa tabi no yume.
She turned to face me.
Watashi wa tabi o shite ta. Nanika o sagasu tabi. Mori no naka o 何日も何日も歩いた。辛かったけど、私、頑張った。大切な人たちがそばにいてくれたから。
I recall the words in my mind.
女の子は夢を見るの。最初は空の夢。夢はだんだん昔へと遡っていく。その夢が女の子を蝕んでいくの。
When Mizu was talking about her dream, she seemed so innocent. She hadn't considered the possibility that her dreams were hurting her.
まあ、ミスズ。
ん？
夢の中のお前はどこにいるんだ？大切な人たちって誰のことだよ？
よくわからないの。考えてもモヤがかかったみたいになってる。でも覚えてるの。
She sounded certain this time. In Mizu's mind, the dreams had remained as images. If the dreams became more distinct, then I might be able to learn something. Meanwhile, I was also sure of something. I couldn't let Mizu continue dreaming.
今日の夢はこれでおしまい。
She sighed, seemingly tired. Her cheeks looked a bit sunken. She hadn't eaten anything today.
何か作ってきてる。
うん。ちょっとお腹空いてるし。でも、もう買い置きがないかな。
Damn, her mom left. Or her auntie, I guess. The auntie left. She only left for 2 days. Oh, God.
ラーメンならまだあった。
インスタントばっかりじゃダメ。
I mean, it's all we got.
ユキトさん、ちゃんと食べないと力が出ないから。今日は、てんやものにしよう。
Oh.
ラーメンライス2つ。
Then that's what he wanted in the beginning.
Yukito-san の分、ご飯をチャーハンにしていいよ。
Oh.
お前はいいのか？
それじゃあ、私もチャーハンにする。
Oh.
Yukito-san とお揃い。にゃは。
She laughed.
電話の下の引き出しにアドレス帳があるから。
The yellow book.
わかった。
Got you. I was just about to leave the room.
Yukito-san.
She called me back.She looked to have made up her mind on something.
Yukito-san, 本当は知ってるんだよね。私の夢が私をこんな風にしてるって。夢を見るたびに私はだんだん弱っていって、最後はきっと。
Damn, she knows.
空にいる女の子と同じになってしまうって。
そんなわけあるか。
怒られちゃった。でも夢を見ないなんてできないから、私が思い出してあげなかったらその子がかわいそうだから。だから私頑張る。ユキトさんも手伝ってほしいな。
Mizu gazed at me questioningly.
もう一人のお前のことなんて考えなくていい。お前はここにしかいない。だからまず病気を治せ。
私はミスズチン。
そうだ。
<Yeah.
S 1> お前はミスズチンだ。
ミスズチン。
ミスズチン、強い子。
She smiled. I left Mizuzu's room and walked down the corridor. I felt like screaming all of a sudden. Where exactly am I right now? It seemed like a long summer dream.That belonged to someone else. A hopeless wish that was wandering back and forth inside the maze. But I understood. Deep within me, I already had an unwavering doubt. This girl would never reach the sea. This girl would not grow up before she disappeared. The sad dream had repeated itself countless times, and yet, I was powerless to do anything. I put out the drawer under the telephone. Mizu's contact number was on top of the address book. After thinking for a bit, I flipped open the notebook. I found a classmate with her class number right after Misuzu. Spin. I turned the dial. I waited and prayed for someone to pick up. Kawaguchi. It was a girl about Misuzu age.
Kawaguchi Shigemika.
I read the name hesitantly from the notebook.
Ima. Kamio Misuzu no ie kara kakete iru. Omae, Misuzu no classmate da
yo. We gotta help her make friends. Her reply was laden with suspicion. This was to be expected. She didn't even know who was on the other line. But now wasn't the time to worry about that.
Imasugu Misuzu, Kamio no tokoro made asobi ni kite kurenai ka?
Sumimasen ga, watashi kore kara kazoku de ryokou ni iku n desu.
Damn.
Sore ja.
Oh. I cried out.
具合が良くないんだ。 俺だけじゃどうにもならない。 誰かの助けが必要なんだ。
え? 神尾さん? また泣いてるんですか?
This time she sounded worried.
分かるのか?
クラス替えの時近くの席だったから 仲良くなりたかったんですけど。 神尾さん泣いちゃって 理由を聞いても教えてくれなくて。 なんかそれっきり気まずい感じになっちゃって。
それはミスズが悪いわけじゃないんだ。とにかく来てくれないか。あ、でも。頼む。今すぐでなきゃならないんだ。あの、失礼ですが、そちらは神尾さんの。
What do you say? I don't know who I am.
俺? 俺は。
What am I? Dump. Someone hit me on the shoulder. I turned around and saw that it was Misuzu in her pajamas. She said calmly. I handed her the phone.
Kamio desu. So. So da yo ne.
Aww.
So nanda. Konakute mo ii kara. Daijoubu da kara. Matteru ne, omiyage. Sore ja.
She put the phone back to its original place. Silence remained.
何やってるんだよ、お前は!
Damn, the music changed suddenly! I wasn't prepared for that! I was shocked for a little bit. I yelled at Mrs.
なぜ自分から一人になろうとするんだよ?
川口さん、 いい人だから。 忙しいのに、 呼び出したらいけないの。
お前と友達になりたいって言ってたぞ。 お前のこと心配してたのに。
うん、知ってる。
Mizu answered me matter-of-factly.
川口さん、すごくいい人。みんなすごくいい人。 ユキトさんも、すごくいい人。 迷惑かけちゃいけないよね。
Her smile tore my heart. I grabbed Mizu's shoulders.
嘘つくなよ。友達が欲しいんだろ。 一人は嫌なんだろ。やりたいことがたくさんあるんだろ。誰かと一緒に思いっきり遊びたいんだろ。
Mizu didn't answer, but I knew why.
友達が近づくだけで、その子は苦しがる。だからその子は、ずっと一人ぼっち。病み始めてしまえば、それから先は早かった。夏はまだ始まったばかりなのに、
She did not want to rely on anyone. She did not want to cause trouble for anyone. She played alone. She laughed alone. She dreamed alone. And then she would vanish like a mirage in the summer. That was the girl in the sky I had been searching for. I gritted my teeth. I let go of her shoulders. I couldn't do anything. I couldn't do a single thing for her. Despite that, Mrs. Zhu told me,
Yukito-san ga ii na. ユキトさん、友達。ユキトさんがいてくれたら、他には誰もいらない。迷惑かな。
She tilted her head. Misuzu's eyes were a clear lake that reflected me. She was so close to me, I could even hear her breath. But I simply looked up at the ceiling. Misuzu was trapped in the sky, even now. She was still suffering. Why did things turn out this way? The sun was setting. I was in Misuzu's room. It was filled with dinosaur plushies that Misuzu loved. There were also Misuzu's table and bed. Everything had taken on an orange tint. Misuzu was sitting on her bed. There was no one else but Misuzu and me. We did nothing. We did not eat. We did not talk. We just sat there staring at each other. I had reached a dead end. I was deep in a maze and had unknowingly wandered into the seaside town. Night was coming soon. Across a large body of air, the sun was shining upon the sea. But none of those meant anything now. Here, a different kind of summer existed. This little room was the only place in the world Misuzu could live now. The cries of the cicadas mingled with the low hum of the air conditioning. The colorless darkness as night slowly filled all four corners of the room. Night came. Fireworks boomed in the distance. Misuzu said in the darkness. She shook her head.
家の前に出れば少しだけ見えるの。私いつも一人で見てた。
Dang, bruh. The booming noise rippled through the air. A great number of people should be watching the sky now. I could picture them in my mind, with their eyes chasing after the vanishing light as blissful smiles decorated their faces.
見てみたいか?
こうしてるだけで綺麗だってわかるから。
そうだな。
In this room, with closed curtains, I could vaguely see Misuzu's features in the darkness. Her smile should be in the center of that darkness. I tried to imagine that single ray of light.
その子を救えるのはあなただけなのだから。
If that were true, that had to be something that I could do. I had to remember.Even if it was something insignificant, I kept mulling over it. When the fireworks ended, Misuzu's pain began. Misuzu doubled over on top of the bed. I heard the sound of the rain, but that was her tears falling onto her lap. When I backed away, Misuzu said,
大丈夫だから、行かないで。
She tried to say something again, but she swallowed her breath.
どうして?私だけ残して。
Her voice oozed out from her constrictive throat. She could no longer suppress her feelings. Misuzu started sobbing before she could finish taking a breath. If her fists continued, her body might break sooner or later. Now that I had become too close to Misuzu, I can't go to her. I had to leave Misuzu now. Misuzu had to be left alone. But I could no longer allow myself to do that. To stay with Misuzu, to hold her in my arms.Was all I wanted to do. Therefore, at the very least, I did that. I held her arm and grasped her hands. Her palm was searing hot. This girl was so delicate. How much more did she have to suffer?
Yukito-san.
Misuzu called my name. I continued to hold her hands.
Tsurakutemo taeiro yo. Ore ga omae no soba ni iru kara. Ore ga omae no soba ni itai kara. Dakara, taeite kure.
Misuzu swallowed her breath.I was so cruel telling her to do such a thing. Misuzu answered me. Then she closed her eyes. She took in slow, deep breaths. Her face was flushed. Sometimes she seemed to stop breathing.
Misuzu, 大丈夫か?
大丈夫.
We stayed like that all night. Morning arrived.
やっと一緒にいられた。寄り添って二人で一緒にいられた。
もう大丈夫なのか。
ありがとう。楽になったよ。
そっか。
A joined hands separated. Misuzu's warmth still remained on my sweaty palm. Misuzu was smiling in the light of dawn.
Yukito-san. Zutto issho ni itte ne.
Ah? Omae ga iyagatta tte sou shite yaru yo.
Ja, zutto zutto issho da ne.
Zutto zutto issho da.
That was Mizuzu's wish. But that, something was set into motion. Even within me. I was under the sky. Misuzu was beside me. She was looking at me. Tears were streaming down her face. They faded into the sunlight, but my body wouldn't move. Even though Misuzu was crying so badly.
Yukito-san!
Misuzu's face was right in front of me. She looked as if she was going to break down crying again.
Yokatta. Mou okinai ka to omotta.
There was a blanket covering me. I felt hot. I took the blanket off me. The sun had already climbed high into the sky. I tried to pull myself up, but I winced immediately. The pain that erupted from my back paralyzed my whole body. What happened to my body?
どうしたの?
別にどうもしない。
どうもしなくてそんな顔にならないよ。
元々こんな顔なんだ。
She might cry again if I kept lying to her. I sat up, leaning against the wall. I didn't think I could stand up anytime soon.
ベッドに戻れよ。
I told Misuzu.
Misuzu, ベッドに戻れ。
ユキトさん、ほっとけないよ。
俺は大丈夫だって。 ちょっと寝れば治る。
私のベッド、使っていいよ。
なあ、ミスズ。 あんまり俺を困らせるな。
うん。
ほら。
I unlit Mizuzu's shoulder and put her back into bed. She still looked doubtful. Sweat had formed on her forehead. She had probably overexerted herself for my sake.
少し眠れ。そばにいてやるから。
Misuzu finally closed her eyes. I sat down against the wall. Mizuzu's lips moved.
Yukito-san.
何だ?
私のせいかな?
I couldn't answer her. The cooler hummed like a chance. We were both sick. We couldn't do anything about it. Sometime later, I finally heard steady breathing coming from the bed. Misuzu must be dreaming again. I put a hand on the wall and stood up with great effort. After that, I left Misuzu's room. I turned on the electric fan. The blue wings churned up the air in the empty room. The pain in my back was still there. Unable to bear it with any longer, I laid down on the spot. This was different from all the injuries or illnesses I've experienced up until now. This pain felt almost like the ache from the old wound. I had no idea what was causing this. I thought about it for a long time. If Misuzu became emotionally attached to anyone, she'd suddenly break down crying. Because her behavior was too strange, everyone distanced themselves from her. But now that I knew Misuzu intimately, I understood that it wasn't so simple. That girl was innocent like a child. She was always enduring hardship. Okay. Time out. You know when they embrace? That's an H scene, bruh. It took me a while to figure that out, but... When he said this, they're intimate now. I'm like, all right, that was an H scene. So, when he embraced her all night, that was actually an A scene. Okay. I had to point that out. She was always enduring hardships. Yet, Misuzu was always alone. Haruko was the only one who could live with her. I'm playing the PSP version, so the PSP version is rated E for everyone. Like it should be, to be honest. Well, maybe the HD is good. I haven't seen it, so I got no opinion of it. But I prefer not to see it, to be honest. That was most likely because of the distance they had kept between themselves. See? My mother's words flashed through my mind. It was perhaps the part I didn't want to remember the most. What did that imply? What if those who got close to Misuzu were subconsciously aware of that fact? Were they aware that they would suffer if they stayed with Misuzu? Just like what was happening to me now? Why couldn't that girl be saved? The act of helping Misuzu would in turn cause her illness to worsen. Finally, the one helping her would also fall ill. It might be that I was aware of it all this time. The closer the two get, the sicker they would become. Then neither of them could be saved. Despite knowing that, I continued to stay by Misuzu's side. I wanted to be by her side more than anyone else. The illness was taking its toll on me. But what else could I do? I sat up and looked up at the sky. It was only the musty ceiling. It might be already be too late. We had become too attached to each other. I looked away from the ceiling. My luggage was sitting in the corner of the living room. The answer was there all along. The closer the two get, the sicker they become. If we distance ourselves, perhaps there was still hope. When my train of thought broke, the sun had already set. I packed up the few belongings I had and stood up. I had stayed beside Misuzu last night. It felt like ages ago. She was standing in the monochrome sunlight. When she saw me, she smiled contentedly.
Yukito-san.
She said to me with a dreamy look.
Umi ni ikitai na. Sunahama de asobu no. Kakekko shitari. Mizu no kake-ai shitari.
What Misuzu wished for? Trifling games that other kids had gotten sick of playing. I couldn't even help her fulfill those simple wishes.
So shite saigo ni. Mata ashita tte.
Damn. So, this is goodbye forever.
Demo, ima wa gaman. Sono hou ga umi made iketa toki ni motto ureshiku naru kara. Misuzu-chin, fight!
To her smiling face, I said,
Sorosoro dete iko to omou nda.
E?
Saisho wa basu dai o kasegu made da to omotte ita. Kedo, iroiro atte nagai ni natte shimatta kara na.
Okane, mada kasegete nai yo ne.
Sonna mono iranai nda yo. Saisho kara iranakatta nda. Arukeba ii nda kara na.
Zutto issho ni ite kureru.
Damn, bro. That was just last night, too!
Sorry. I'm sorry about that. It's a battle. I can't stay in one place.
You know what's more messed up? You played the 18 plus version? That's right after the H scene, bruh! It's like a one and done. That's fucked up. I avoided her gaze.
これから頑張ろうとしてたのに。ユキトさんにいてほしいな。ずっといてほしいな。Damn.
I knew she wouldn't accept my leaving. So I told her.
なあ、ミスズ。お前が俺を苦しめているんだよ。わかるか?
He's not wrong. He is dying a little bit.
お前はずっと一人ぼっちだった。今だんだん体が動かなくなってきている。心当たりあるだろう。このまま行くとお前はある。はずのない痛みを感じるようになる。そしてお前は全てを忘れていく。一番大切な人間のことさえ思い出せなくなる。そして最後の夢を見終わった朝、お前は
I stood
there silently.
Damn, bro. Damn, her sprite looks so sad, too.
一人で?
Ah.
やっと一人じゃなくなったのに。
お前にはほら、春子がいるじゃないか。
そうだけど。
Mizu was silent for a while, but she finally spoke up.
じゃあ、仕方ないね。
Dang.
仕方ないよね。
She repeated herself. I understood. If I continue to stay with you, I'll be the one to collapse first. Once I told her that, Mizu wouldn't try to hold me back. The closer the two get, the sicker they'll become. If that were true, then we had to distance ourselves from each other. I had to become as much of a stranger as when I first met her. Then Mizu would give up following me. Then Mizu could forget about me. That was the only solution that I could think of.
いつ出るの?
今日。
すぐ?
あ、今すぐだ。
もう一晩だけ泊まっていけばいいのに。
Damn, we stay one more night, it might be too late though.
俺はお前が寝ている間に苦しむんだよ。
あ、そっか。
Dang. You know, it is true what he's saying, he was in pain. But he's only saying that because that's the only way to convince Mizuzu, right? Like, if he's in pain, then she'll make sacrifices.But then if he stayed worrying about her, she doesn't really care what happened to her, right? She just want to be with him.
じゃあ、これでさよならだね。
そうだな。
あのね、ユキトさん。
なんだ?
楽しかった、この夏休み。ユキトさんと過ごした、この夏休み。一番楽しかった。
そっか。
私も、頑張れてよかった。
そっか。
ユキトさん、私にできた初めての友達。
そうだな。
きっとユキトさんいなかったらもっと早く諦めてたと思う。
バカ、これからも頑張るんだろう。お前は。
そっか、そうだよね。
She began to lay the cards out on her bed. Plat plat.Until the very last, Mizu was still playing cards. I watched her for a while. This very activity symbolizes Mizu.
やっぱり、こうして一人で遊んでいればよかったんだね。
そうかもな。でもな、楽しかったよ、俺も。
本当?
ああ、ミスズと過ごせてよかった。
I meant what I said.
私もよかった。
プラップラッ。
じゃあ、行くな、俺。
うん。
じゃあな。
うん。バイバイ、ユキトさん。
Mizu watched me leave, with her car still laid out on her lap.
バイバイ。
Damn, bro, this is kind of more fucked up. I think I prefer if she dies than we leave her. Because, I don't know, man.I feel like a heartbroken is like worse than death. I left the room.
さて。
Where should I go now? I better get away from this house first. I'll leave town either tomorrow or the day after. While I was pondering what to do, I heard a noise behind me. Oh, she followed. I turned around and saw Mizuzu.
どうした?
あのね。今朝の夢、私一人ぼっちで閉じ込められてた。寂しかった。誰かが連れ出してくれるのをずっと待ってた。
She was looking into my eyes.
私ね、一緒に行きたい。
おお。
ユキトさんと一緒に行きたい。ついて行ったら。
Come on, bro. Just let it be, bro. Her final wish. Just let it come true. I cover my eyes with my hand.
バカかお前は。俺はこの家を去りたいわけじゃない。お前から離れたいだけなんだ。
Damn.
あ、そっか。そうだよね。ごめんね、またバカなこと言って。
And she said she felt like she was in a prison. She wants someone to save her.
Matakuda.
Ja, bye bye.
Damn.
Genki de ne.
Ah, omae. Ganbare yo na. Hitori demo ganbare yo na.
Hitori demo ganbaru.
Omae wa tsuyoi mon na.
Watashi, tsuyoi ko.
Yoshi.
I put my hand on her head.
Jana.
With those parting words, I turned away from Misuzu. Before I turned the corner, I looked back for the last time. Misuzu noticed and flashed me a V sign at me. She had her chest puffed out and her hand high in the air. That was the last I saw of Misuzu. I walked alone along familiar roads. What I had been doing in this town all this time? I had accomplished nothing. I had abandoned everything. If I had known, I wouldn't have come to this town. I wish I had never begun my search for the girl in the sky. I decided to quit brooding. I was just going around in circles. I had no other choice. I could only tell myself that. For now, I'll wait for the sun to rise. Tomorrow's problems are for tomorrow. That was how I lived my life. After coming to that conclusion, I searched for a place to sleep. The seawall. I spent the whole day in a state of lethargy. Several buses had passed me by. Because I was laying on the bench, every bus stopped for me. In the end, no one got off. I didn't get in, and the buses left. The stifling heat and the exhaust left behind by the buses enveloped me. When I breathed in, the smell of the sea filled my nose. It was the smell I had gotten used to. The sun continued to beat down on my naked neck. Nobody in their right mind would go to the next town on foot in this heat. If I had known, I would have left in the night when the weather was still cool. Besides, you should have should have packed it to go. It all began here. I recall the day I got off the bus in this town. I tried to sell my show to some kids passing by, but one of them kicked my puppets and sent it flying. It got overtaken by an elderly woman, lost unconscious, and woke up in a fishing union. And then I met her. On that seawall, Misuzu and I met for the first time. An experience that would never happen again. In the end, I wasn't able to bring Misuzu to the beach. But that was no longer my duty. I look in the direction of the sea breeze. Let's stop thinking about it. I won't set foot in this town again. I won't see Misuzu again. My health is getting better. My feet feels light. Perhaps Misuzu has already completely recovered by now. I got up. But then I sat back down again. I repeated the same action many times. The bus stopped and went. Have I dozed off? The sound of children woke me up. I saw a little girl who was encircled by her group of friends. They were playing together. Such a scene was commonplace. I could see this in any town. But this girl's smile looks like
Misuzu.
Surrounded by her friends, she was smiling non-stop. I watched on. Even this normal life was out of Misuzu's reach. This was what she always wished for, but she failed to see it to fruition. But was she able to get a little taste of a normal life when I was with her? Her mother had left her. I had left her. And now she's alone. What is she thinking about? She's not crying, was she? But that girl always wore a smile on her face. She wouldn't cry, no matter how difficult life got. I closed my eyes once more. A picture of the vast sky materialized before me. I heard a voice. It was my mother. She was inviting me, who had been alone all this time, to go on a journey with her. In my hand was my puppet. The joyous voices of children continue unabated. Once more, I closed my eyes. The sounds of laughter and the memories of my childhood became rolled into one. I was on a street in town. A crowd of people had gathered. I slipped between the legs of the adults and emerged at the front. Before me was a scene right out of a fairy tale. Balls, knives, mirrors, ribbons, clocks. Numerous objects floated, flew about, and spun in midair. It looked almost like a tiny circus. A woman stood in the center of all. In rhythm to a woman dance, the props were parading in midair, infused with life. I watched transfixed amidst the raucous cheers and the stench of sweat. A miniature world that seemed like a miniature dream. When everyone else had left, the woman turned to speak to me.
Konnichiwa.
This woman was my mother. All this while, I had been left in the care of an old temple. Oh, he's not even related to her, bruh. My mother, who was my only kin, had entrusted me to the temple and gone somewhere. Is that his mother? I didn't know what to make of that.
この人形はね、人を笑わせる、楽しませることができる道具。ほら、持って、動かしてみて。
Maybe it is his mother.
こうするのよ。指先を当てて。
I'm not gonna lie, my throat hurts. So I'm rubbing my neck. She pressed my fingers onto the puppet.
思えば通じる。思いは通じるから。
But the puppet did not move.
今、ユキトはどう思ってる?
Oh, it is his mother.
人を笑わせたいと思ってる? そうじゃないと動かないよ。 動かしたい思いだけじゃなくて、 その先の願いに触れて、人形は動き出すんだから。
I had no idea what she was talking about. Oh, what the hell was that? What the fuck? Don't worry about that. It's my PSP. My PSP is acting up. In the end, I wasn't able to move the puppet.
Yukito, kinasai. Kochi. Hora. Yukito to onaji doshi gurai no kodomo ga ippai iru kara. Dakara, sono ningyo o motte ikinasai. Sono chikara de minna o warawasete ageru no.
I didn't see the point of it. Even when I was thrown in their midst, I wasn't able to make the puppet move. When everyone had left, my mother hugged me.
Yukito は誰にも笑ってほしくない。私は笑ってほしいな。出会った人たち、みんな。
If she was being honest, then she must be incredible. After that, my mother did her best to teach me something, something important.
この空の向こうには翼を持った少女がいる。それはずっと昔から。そして今この時も同じ大気の中で翼を広げて風を受け続けている。そこで少女は同じ夢を見続けている。 彼女はいつでも一人きりで大人になれずに消えていく。そんな悲しい夢を何度でも繰り返す。私はずっと旅を続けてきたの。空にいる少女を探す旅。私のお母さんもお母さんのお母さんもずっとそうしてきた。そしてみんなその子に出会った。とても悲しい思いをした。 でもね、ユキト。私はあなたにそれを強要はしたくないの。あなたはあなたの幸せを見つけて。人は自分の幸せを見つけるために生きているんだから。ね、ユキト。
A month went by. Then my mother told me.
これから私は旅に戻る。それが私のなりわいだから。いろんな人たちを笑わせるのが私の生きがいだから。 もしこんな私でも家族だと思ってくれるなら、私はあなたを連れて行くことができる。けど、私にそんな権利なんてないと思うから、それはあなたが決めて。This
first month I spent with my mother. She had been desperately trying to teach me something. Did I learn anything from her? No, nothing at all. It wasn't any different as compared to when I was still alone. It was the morning when she was due to leave. My mother had finished preparing for a journey. She was standing with her back to the morning sun. I looked at her while still dressed in my sleeping clothes.
Yukito wa koko ni nokoru? Sore tomo issho ni iku? Issho ni iku?
I nodded. I was still a child. Young and ignorant, I chose to follow my mother. The journey I took with her, it did not even last a year. Every time we arrived at a small town, my mother would quickly lay out her props and begin a street performance. I felt a sense of pride when both the adults and children looked on with wonder. At night, I slept beside her. I felt my mother warmth. She was my first kin. I bought her puppets to begin to train my powers. At first, I didn't know how to move the puppets at all, but my mother drilled it into me. One night, the puppet finally walked. My mother patted my head. I simply continued to move the puppet with all my heart. I wanted to see my mother smile at me. That was all. But that was the beginning of our party. It was a summer night. The firewood was burning. My mother spoke to me in a steadily voice.
でも何一つしてあげられなかった。夏はまだ始まったばかりなのに知っていたのに私は何もできなかった。誰よりもその子のそばにいたのに救えなかった。
She uttered each word surely and carefully.
女の子は夢を見るの。最初は空の夢。夢はだんだん昔へと遡っていく。その夢が女の子を蝕んでいくの。
I couldn't understand some of the words that were being said, but I listened carefully. I understood that she was trying to tell me something important.
最初は だんだん体が動かなくなる。それから、ある、はずのない痛みを感じるようになる。そして、女の子は、すべてを忘れていく。一番大切な人のことさえ、思い出せなくなる。そして、最後の夢を見終わった朝、女の子は、死んでしまうの。She
paused for a moment. She seems to be holding back her emotions.
二人の心が近づけば、二人とも病んでしまう。二人とも助からない。だから、その子は言ってくれたの。私から離れてって。Damn,
that's what fucking Yukito did.
優しくて、とても強い子だったの。He
left her.
だから、ユキト。 今度こそ、あなたが救ってほしいの。その子を救えるのは、あなただけなのだから。She
held up the puppet at me.
この人形の中にはね、叶わなかった願いが込められてるの。Dang,
the puppet. It's like a curse, to be honest. To be honest, it's a curse.
私のお母さんも、お母さんのお母さんも、ずっとそうしてきた。 衰えてしまう前に、この人形に力を封じ込めてきた。いつか誰かが願いを解き放つ時のために、だから私も願いの一つになる。She
looked at me straight in the eye.
Yukito.
When she called my name, I couldn't look away for some reason.
今、私が話していることを、あなたはすべて忘れてしまう。それも、 私が受け継いだ力の一つ。あなたが思い出さなければ、私たちの願いはそこで終わる。これは本当なら許されないこと。当たり前の母親に憧れ続けた私のわがまま。あなたには自分の意思で道を決めてほしいから。She
placed the puppets in my hand.
今からこれは あなたのもの。 これをどう使うかは、あなたの自由。ただお金を稼ぐためだけに人形を動かしてもいい。旅をやめてしまってもいい。人形を捨ててしまってもいい。空にいる女の子のことは忘れて生きていってもいい。 でもね、ユキト、きっと思い出す時が来る。あなたの血がその子と引き合うから。どこかの町であなたはきっと女の子に出会う。優しくてとても強い子。その子のことをどうしても助けてあげたいと思ったら、人形に心を込めなさい。私はあなたと共にあるから。
Damn, it's too late! Damn, we leave! I didn't have the option though.
その時まで。
Then, something unbelievable happened. My mother body slowly faded away, right in front of me. It was as though she had never existed to begin with.
さよなら。
In her final moment, she smiled brilliantly at me. And then she was no more. When I came to, there was no one there. Only her tiny puppet remained. The fire lulled in tongues, seemingly indifferent to all that had happened. I couldn't remember anything. My mother must have abandoned me. At my age, that was the only answer I could arrive at. With my puppet in hand, I began to search for my mother. Day after day, I looked for her. Originally, it had only begun as a journey to find my mother. I just wanted to see my mother smile again. When I finally acknowledged that my mother was no longer around, the purpose of my journey changed. I remember bits of what my mother taught me. There is a girl in the sky. She is bound by never-ending sadness. So I decided that I was going to make that girl laugh. With a new purpose in mind, I began walking. What I lost that day, I should have tried to recover it. However, I began to see... What? The music stopped. To see my puppet as nothing more than a tool to act out a living. Is this how it's supposed to be? Right. It turned into something I used to make money off the appearance of others. Oh, okay. That's how it's supposed to be. How many summers have passed since then? In this town, I met a girl who was all alone. She was always by my side and smiling at me. These summer days that I spent under this blue sky, with Misuzu always by my side, she was always laughing. I have found it. This was what I lost on that day. Since that day, I had lived only to find what I had lost. And I finally did. I just needed someone who was smiling for me. I just wanted to make someone happy. I just wanted to make someone happy with my own powers. Nothing else mattered. What I had been searching for turned out to be something so plain and ordinary. Someone who I want to bring a smile to. She was the girl I met at the seaside town. She was always bubbly. She was always with me. She was always showing me her laughter. At this moment, I was about to lose her. Why am I always too late to notice? Am I going to lose something again?
このお兄さん、さっきから変だよ。
What the hell is going on?
暑いから病気になっちゃったのかな?
Womp! I sat up. The children scattered.
待て!
I caught one of them.
頼む!助けてくれ!
I bowed at the girl. The girl looked surprised, but she did not run away from me.
とりあえずこれを見てほしいんだ。
I took out my puppet.
人形さん。
今からこの人形さんが歩いてみせるからな。
本当？
ああ。
I rested my puppet on the ground, and then I wished upon it. The puppet stood up.
わあ、すごい。
Taro, Taro. It started walking. The girl watched my puppet's movement.
どうだ？
面白
いか？
不思議だけど、面白くはないよ。
だよな。だからな。助けてほしいんだ。
何を？
どうすれば面白くなるか。見ている人が笑えるようになるか。
ちょっと待ってね。みんな。
The girl called her friends over.
どうした？ユリッペ。
A gaggle of children had suddenly gathered around me. Somewhere along the way, I had forgotten how to bring laughter to people. Would I be able to regain that ability? I spent the afternoon taking a lesson from the children. They nagged me from time to time because I was a slow learner. But these children did not give up on me. They were patient, as long as I was willing to listen to the criticism. At last, Taro, 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 plop! The puppet fell down as though it had been tripped over something. The children laughed heartily.
今の面白かった。
そうか。
うん。
どこが面白かった？
ね、 全部面白かったよ。
そうか。
It wasn't just about making other laughs. As long as someone could laugh for my sake, I was happy. So I poured all my heart into moving my puppet. I finally recalled what my mother said to me.
人形に心を込めなさい。
I had a newfound confidence.
もう帰っていい?
And then the children said, she sounded as if she was going to cry.
母さん心配するから。
ああ、悪かった。サンキュ
ー。バイバイ。
ああ、バイバイ。
The children waved at me and left. I got prepared to leave. I packed up the little belongings I had. Then I went back down the path I came from. My pace had picked up without my knowing. This road I had walked with Misuzu. This town where I lived with Misuzu. Breathless, I turned the corner. A familiar scenery lay before me. But in this everlasting summer, only one thing was missing from the picture. It was the lone girl who had smiled at me when I came to the sound.
浜辺に行こう。
は？
浜辺、そこ。
Why should I?
遊びたいから。ゆうべ、寝てましたよね。よっぽど疲れてたんですね。疲れは取れましたか？今日は暇ですか？やっぱりダメかな。
いや。
Dang, dude. She just wanna make friends.
疲れも取れたし、今日からずっと暇だ。
Oh, wait a minute. You think, Mizuru, she forget, right? Did she forget everything? So now they can start fresh?
だから、夏休み、目いっぱい遊ぼうな。
What the fuck does wait 2000 mean? What? Do I wait 2000 seconds?I'm curious, but I'm also impatient. Oh, what? Is that GG's? Oh! Wait, don't clap yet. Hey, y'all. Hey! Do-do-do!That's not bad. Not bad, not bad, not bad. Not bad for the first opening. Right? I say opening. First route. Usually the first route for every Key Studio video game or visual novel. It sets the mood. Right? Like Nagisa route. Rin route. I think that's the name, right? Rin? Right? From Little Busters.And then, I think Kotori's the first girl, to be honest. Excuse me. They always set the mood. Excuse me. I think this is like the only one with a happy ending, right? I never played Kanan before. Kanan might have a happy ending for the first round. But I think this is a happy ending. Yeah, Misuzu forget everything, but they can have a fresh start. Hey. He might be able to save her.It's probably going to lead up to the final round, obviously. So. You know, first impression of the first round. I like this game a lot. This game is really good. I don't know how I feel about it compared to the other Key Studio visual novels, but this one's really good. I like this one a lot.Is it because of the characters? Maybe. I like the characters a lot. Is it because of the music? Yeah, the music's really good. I like it a lot. Is it because of the character design? Yeah, I think the characters are pretty cool. I like Potato a lot. I think it's off with a really good first impression. This was a really good first impression of the first route that I did for Key. Air. The cold air from the cooler was stagnating in this dark room. Mizu was sleeping. Even her breathing sounded painful. Oh shit. Never mind, it's not a happy ending. I observed Mizu's face. It was the face of someone who had given up hope of getting help.
Mizu.
Damn, bro, I got fucking baited. Holy fuck. Damn, they baited me. Damn, I thought they were gonna have a fresh start. Nah, she's dead, bro. I sat down in the spot where I usually sat.
Dude,
what the fuck? Damn, they did the ultimate bait and switch. She never woke up. Oh, I was saying this is like the first happy ending on the first route of a key studio that I read. Cause Renrao was like super, super sad. And Clannad, you know, Nagisa, you know after Nagisa, bruh. So I thought maybe Misuzu might be fine. Nah. I shook her shoulder gently.
Misuzu, ore da.
I called her name.
Misuzu.
She finally cracked open her eyelids.
Misuzu, wakaru ka? Ore da.
Yukito-san.
Oh. Her voice was weak. She sounded like someone who was bedridden for years. Damn, Junmaide being Junmaide, bruh. I thought, you know, this is one of his early works, so he wasn't twisted yet. He always been twisted.
I
took out my puppets and placed it at her bedside. Then I wish upon my puppet, Taro Taro, Taro Taro.
Omoshiroidaro. Misuzu, mite kureteru ka?
Bro, she's dead.
Okashiidaro.
Oh! Damn! Misuzu's eyes were no longer open.
Misuzu, okiro yo.
Bruh.
Mite kure yo. Sore de waratte kure yo.
Damn, bruh. Oh, damn. Dang. I held Misuzu's hand. She held back weakly. Her fingers were cold to the touch.
It's too late.
Time passed. I did not leave Misuzu's side. I simply made my puppet move with all my willpower. Misuzu, I finally found what I was looking for. You are my treasure. You are my happiness. You're going to stay here forever. No matter what happens. No matter what happens to you and me, we will be here, together. I will never leave you. We will find happiness.
No. Misuzu.
I saw a wavering white light through my closed eyelids. Is it morning? Open my eyes. However, it was not dawn that I saw. It was something unbelievable. My puppet was radiating an intense white light. It made me squint. I felt as if my consciousness were being sucked into the puppet. I was enveloped by something warm. My mind was becoming clearer like a wind washing over me. What's going on?
Yukito?
I heard a voice.
今こそ思い出しなさい。
Oh, shit. Damn, the opening, bro. One of the best songs. Her voice brought back sleeping memories. With my consciousness leaving me, I looked around for Misuzu. There was nothing else I needed to recall. I didn't care what I needed to do. All I wanted was to be with her. All I wanted was to spend these uneventful days together with Misuzu. All I want was to make Misuzu smile. Once more. If I can just start over. Once more. Then I will, without an inkling of a doubt, choose to be with you. Oh, shit! Damn, he always be doing this, bro. I didn't know that. I thought that was like, you know, when I first read Little Busters, I'm like, damn, what the heck? Right? And then I read Clannad, I'm like, oh shit, it came from Clannad. Now I'm reading Air, I'm like, oh fuck, it came from Air. The plot twist, it came from canon. And then the further plot twist, it came from before canon. I forgot the other ones. Then it finally happened. The surroundings became filled with light. Oh, what happened? That was going to turn back time. I'm not going to lie. Okay. She kind of reminds me of Makoto, not gonna lie.
Yukito-san? Doko ni itchatta no? Modotte kite kuretan da yo ne? Yukito-san? Ne, watashi...
Oh, what the fuck happened? He's dead!
Mada ganbare sou da yo.
Wait!
Ne? Yukito-san.
What the fuck?
Yukito-san.
What happened? Wait a minute! Oh my god! He fucking killed himself! Oh my god! Just like his mom, he just disintegrated into existence and turned into a doll to make his wish come true. They did pull a Little Busters Clannad, Air, and probably canon. I didn't even know Jemite keep turning back time in every games he make. He always go back in time. Dang, what's the appendix? TV. Only unlocked 9%. That makes sense. This is technically an introductory route anyway. So, the only thing we really got is a V. Guess we got this one too. And then when she's sleeping. Dang, she woke up because Yukito is gone. Right? They're only sick because they were together. Now that Yukito is gone, she's okay. Damn. Junmaide. I didn't know it's a tradition, bruh. To kill your main heroines like this. No! He did a twist! He killed the main character this time! I didn't expect that. That was the last thing in my mind. I known him from the future. Well, I guess the peak Key Studio days, right? With Little Busters and Clannad. Him killing off the heroines, I'm like, that's nothing new. He'd been doing that in the future. So I thought he got it from the past. In the past, he didn't kill the heroine. He killed the main character. I was like, wait a minute. What? She's okay. What happened? How is she fine? She's fine because the main character is gone. Holy shit. Mind blown. That's pretty cool. Now I wonder what happened in canon. I watched the anime for canon. But one of them have to die, right? In the first round. There's no way. It has to be a tradition for Junmaide. He has to kill one main character in the first round. With the main girl round, I should say. The main poster girl, right? Either the poster girl or the main character gotta die. It's one or the other. Dang. He did that in the spinoff too, bruh. Tomoyo after. Junmaide is an asshole. Oh shit. Why is he like that? Maybe that's why he's such a genius though. And his stories are so good. Because he's willing to make sacrifices. And those sacrifices hurt. Like hell. these things. But the good thing about this sacrifice is, right, just like with Clannad and Little Buster is, we know there's a true route that fix everything. So even though the first route may leave like a very sad taste in your mouth, right? If you're familiar with Key Studio, the true route is going to fix everything. So if I wasn't familiar with Key Studio visual novels, I would probably be crying a little bit. But I know there's going to be a true route and everyone's going to be okay after the true route. It's always like that in Key Studio. Well, at least with Jun Maide, right? Anyway, that was good. That was good. They just say, Misuzu. So, all these pictures, Misuzus. Oh, what the hell? Hey, spoilers, don't look at the other girls. Now, I'm curious, who's the third girl? Oh, I know already. It's the one with Potato, right? So, the next girl we're going to do is... We're actually going to do her. We're going to do Kirishima. Dang. Hey, is she the... Dang, I got to look at the VODs. Kirishima. Is this the girl with the family trip? That going to make me feel some type of way. That is that girl. So far, my favorite girl, obviously, Misuzu. But I also like Tono. Right? Because she reminds me of Kotomi. And Clannad. Kotomi for Clannad is probably Tono, basically. That's probably her parent character. Where she got inspired from the most. And they were like, let's put her in Clannad. Let's call her Kotomi. Because she has like a very soft voice. That's pretty much it. That's the only thing they have something similar. She may not be a book nerd, but she has a very soft voice. And I like that a lot. But we're going to do her. Because she has Potato. We got to know more about Potato. That's first priority. So that's going to be the next route. And with that, I appreciate everyone that stopped by. It's been cool. We'll play more Air next time. Laters. Bye.